Draco?
That's right.
Candy Wrap, the clear new economy sandwich wrap for lunchboxes, and new Men and Break, world's first man-sized deodorant with a wide roller top. New Men and Break, present tonight's Michael Shayne.
Uh-oh, another leaky sandwich. If your family has ever complained about messy lunchbox lunches, you ought to use clear new Handy Wrap. Unlike ordinary sandwich wrap, new Handy Wrap just won't leak. Keep sandwiches fresher, even when sharply creased. To prove it, I folded this piece of Handy Wrap and creased it again and again. Handy Wrap is so easy to handle, and it doesn't rip or tear. Now I'm pouring scalding hot coffee into this creased sheet of Handy Wrap. Imagine what would happen to ordinary wrap. But Handy Wrap locks in freshness, even when sharply creased. See? Not a hint of a leak. Giant 100-foot roll wraps 100 sandwiches, yet Handy Wrap is economically priced like wax paper. Yes, you get 100 feet of Handy Wrap economically priced like wax paper.
Handy Wrap, product of the Dow Chemical Company.
Say, hey, you ever run into a fella named Draco? Jimmy Draco.
No, I don't think so. What about him?
Nothing. Except I thought maybe you might have heard something like, maybe if any of the fellers is after him.
Me? You're the one with the big ears.
Well, it's his headache anyhow.
You all right?
I'm gonna get this here. Pays lately real bad. Give him another shot, will you?
You better see a doctor.
Are you kidding? I don't even have the price of a drink.
Go down to the county hospital.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Saw this here Draco clear, but I got a pretty good look at one of the guys worked him over. Oh, I found this here nearby.
Silver button?
Mm.
Pretty fancy for a muscle man.
Well, maybe it belonged to Draco.
Or it may have been lying there for a week. What's this Jimmy Draco to you?
Nothing. I never saw him before.
How about a drink?
You know me.
Yeah, that's why I'm wondering why you're here.
Well, I'm here to ask for help.
What, for a guy you don't even know?
I get it. You figure old Harry Burke's got to have an angle before he opens his mouth, huh?
Well, that's how it's been.
Well, ain't that way no more. I didn't want to say nothing, because I don't want nobody to pity me. But I'm feeling kind of poorly lately, and, you know, I ain't been hitting on all my cylinders. I went down to county hospital for a checkup. I'm finished.
What's the gag?
Fella don't joke about a thing like this. May give me 6 months, maybe less.
Harry, are you sure?
That's sure. Look at me. I look like I'm dying to you.
Oh, now, there must be something they can do.
Nope. Nothing. I ain't got no regrets. I picked my life and I lived it. Except for one thing. I never done nothing except for dough for myself. Just this one time, I like to do something for somebody else. Just this one thing. You get me?
I get you. So you picked out this Jimmy Draco?
He picked me out. I figure somebody give me a chance to do something, I don't want to muff it.
I'd go see McCord if I were you.
McCord? He's a cop.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Well, I ain't about to ask for no favor from no cop. I mean, dying don't change me that much. Forget I ever come in here.
Only there's one fella's gonna lose out, and that's that Jimmy Draco, if he ain't dead already.
Harry.
Oh.
Let's go see McCord.
Well, now, can't we do this thing together? Just you and me?
McCord's got a whole police force to help him.
I'll tell you one thing. I'll bet you don't believe me.
Let's find out.
You made up this story, didn't you, Harry? Figured Mike could give you a couple of bucks.
See? What I tell you, Mike, they're all the same.
I know you, Harry, and I know your record. Wino, petty thief, stool pigeon.
I am telling the truth.
Ever had the DTs?
I had everything. So what?
So I say you had them Sunday night.
Look, I just been told I only have about 6 months left to live. Now, why would I go around and tell a bunch of phony stories? Even a cop ought to be able to figure that one out.
He's on the level, Mac.
All right, Harry. But why haven't we had a missing persons report?
I don't know. But he's never given me a bum steer. And he found this.
Right up where they whipped him, too.
James Draco, huh?
Drabert, Drakeman, Drake.
No Draco, James, or otherwise.
Information? This is the police, Sergeant McCord. Do you have a listing on a James Draco, please? D-R-A-C-O. Or K-O. 7321. Uh-huh. And the address? 638 Foxcroft. Okay, thank you. New listings. Flower shop and an apartment.
Okay, Mike. Let's go. You too, Harry. We'll need you for identification.
Sure.
McCord.
Is there something wrong?
Are you Mrs. Draco?
Yes, I'm Rosalind Draco.
You run the shop alone?
My husband and I.
Is your husband here?
Well, he's in the back.
May we see him?
Jimmy, will you come out here a minute?
What is it, dear?
These men were asking to see you.
Are you James Draco?
That's right.
McCord. It's Harry Burke, Mike Shayne.
Well, Harry?
I don't know.
What's it all about?
Where were you Sunday night?
Sunday, I was home watching television with Roz.
Is that right, Mrs. Draco?
Why, yes.
Lester? I saw a fella with your name get worked over real good the other night down by the waterfront.
There's a lot of waterfront around here, but I've seen very little of it.
You got a driver's license?
Yeah. New York. Here's some credit cards, National Florist Association. Anything else?
That's all. Nice place. Good luck.
Sorry we took up your time.
Sorry I couldn't help.
Come on, Harry.
Character in there. I don't know. There's something fishy about him.
Oh, Harry, get a drink and forget it.
Mike, I gave you the straight dope, honest.
Come on, we'll check the mug books. Well, here's the last one. What do you hear from Gentry?
I got a card this morning. He's not catching any fish, but he's getting a beautiful tan.
Hey, here he is.
Dave Fazio.
Dave Fazio? You saw him?
That's a fella.
Dave Fazio killed a man 2 years ago, and he's in the state pen for life.
Harry, I'm closing up.
What do you mean, closing up?
You've had enough. You know, you can carry this dying bit too far.
Dying? Who's going to die? I'm going to live forever. At least another 6 months. Here you are. Keep a change.
Well, you're pretty generous all of a sudden, ain't you?
No, I'm a guest of the Miami Police Department. Leastwise, they want to get rid of me, so Shayne gave me $20 to live it up, so I'm going to live it up.
Howdy, friend. Have a drink with me?
Same.
Hey, Pete. Hear me, same.
I'm sorry, the bar's closed.
What are you doing to me?
I got rules. You want me to get shut down?
Shut down. Sorry, friend. Say, my name's Harry Burke.
Steve Andrews.
You new around here?
Yeah. See you around.
See you.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going to get out of here.
Yeah, but they said you'd be here for a week.
When a feller's only got 6 months, he can't afford to lose a week. Cops ever find that car hit me?
No, not yet.
Can't they do anything right?
About that car, Harry. You know, that could be somebody trying to keep you quiet.
Hmm.
Now, what do you think?
I think it's a good thing I was too drunk to be able to walk straight.
Look, you stay off the streets for a while.
How do you expect me to do that?
You know, I just happen to have a due bill at the Beardsley Hotel.
Well, I think old Mike Shayne is coming around to old Harry Burke's way of thinking.
Yeah, but it was the car that did it. Now, come on, I'll check you out. Mr. Shayne, how are you?
Oh, fine, thanks. Just stopped in for some flowers. Let's see. Yeah, a couple of those orchids are all right. Now, just make them up as a corsage, hmm?
Yeah, that's my wife's department. She's just down the street getting some change. She'll be back in a minute.
Oh, well, I'm in kind of a hurry. Just something simple, nothing fancy.
Well, if you don't mind, second best. Police find the man that was beaten up, assuming there was a man. Mm. Personally, I think that old guy was a little upset. Funny thing, him hearing my name, though. Aren't many of us Dracos around.
Well, hello.
Hello, Mr. Shayne.
Mrs. Draco, I stopped in for an orchid corsage, but your husband doesn't seem to be doing too well.
Let me, honey. They're very pretty. I hope they're going to someone special.
My wife is an incurable romanticist.
May I have a card, please?
Mm-hmm.
And a pen? Did you have a flower shop in New York?
Yeah. Well, Roz ran it.
There.
Very nice. How much is that?
$10.
There we are.
Come in again.
Thank you, I will.
He might just be onto something.
I hope he is.
Roz, darling, I prefer positive thinking. Remember that.
Doctors know men who work under tension can have tension odor. But now comes an amazing new deodorant with a giant roller top that knocks out a man's tension odor. New Men and Break. Stroke for stroke, Break packs more power than any woman's roll-on. Until today, men have used this type deodorant. A woman may want delicate roll-ons like these. But a man wants Break. Stroke for stroke, Break with its giant roller top packs the power to knock out a man's perspiration in a way no woman's roll-on does. Yes, stroke for stroke, Break packs more power, more protection than any woman's roll-on. Get new Men and Break, world's first man-sized deodorant.
Darling. Mike, who is she?
No, not this time.
Well, it's a natural curiosity. You mind if I open it?
Ah. Look, the real message is on the outside of this. That guy's fingerprints.
Oh, Mike, you're wasting your time.
Yeah? All right, look at this.
Flowers.
Simple, though, huh? Now, any florist in town could have made this up in 2 minutes, but Draco couldn't. His wife had to do it.
All right, Mike, I'll check out the prints.
You better try New York, too.
Yeah, well, where's Harry now?
Staying at the Beardsley.
Nice payoff for a nightmare.
Look, that was no nightmare.
Mike, right after you came in with Burke, I checked with the Weather Bureau. And here's their report. There was a low-level cloud cover and no moon. It's not likely he saw much of anything.
Sort of like tonight, huh?
So what?
So I may go down there and have a look.
Have fun.
Now, here, you might as well give that to some deserving girl.
I don't need flowers.
Always mother.
Mike, anything new on Harry Burke?
Yeah, maybe. Want to take a ride?
Sure.
Come on. Where he saw Draco get it.
I wonder if you could see a man's face out there.
Walk through the arch and around the corner, then step into the light. We'll see.
Clobbered me.
Call McCord.
I want a lawyer.
First talk.
First a lawyer. You hear me? A lawyer.
First us, then the lawyer.
I got my rights. One phone call.
I say when. Now who hired you?
My grandmother.
Look, you tried to cut me up and I want to know why. Now, who hired you?
Nobody.
You've got 500 bucks in this wallet. Where'd you get it?
The track.
The track's closed.
A bookie.
I say it's a down payment on a killing. Mine.
You say. I don't care what you say.
You'll care. Before I'm through with you, you'll care plenty.
Easy, Mike. Not here.
You see what kind of a cat he is? A nut. He comes after me with a stick.
Bix, you're in for assault with a deadly weapon. Give yourself a break.
Save the snow job. I want a lawyer!
Get this guy out of here. You're gonna get the book, page by page, everything.
Tell it to the judge. My phone call? It's okay. No time.
What about the other one?
He's in the hospital. These are real pros. They don't talk.
I'm breathing down somebody's neck, and whoever it is doesn't like it.
Yeah. Do me a favor, Mike, and pack a gun.
Yeah. Right now, it's not me I'm worried about.
Harry?
That car thing. It was no accident. I'll try again.
Yep, son. I know them all. Capone, Greasy Thumb, Joe the Tomb.
Did you ever work for him?
Nah. Not that I couldn't. I just wouldn't.
This is it.
Who's there?
It's Mike, Harry.
Oh, just a minute, Mike.
Come on in.
Joe filled me in. What happened to you? Everything all right?
Yeah, fine.
Harry, I owe you an apology.
Well, thank you kindly. With that and a dime, I might be able to get a ride on a bus.
Oh, now, wait a minute. You're still target number one. Max got two men posted outside your door right now.
What, am I in jail?
Oh, now, what jail ever served champagne?
You know, it's a funny thing, Mike.
What?
Well, I'm pressing so hard all these years to get to be a big shot. Now I finally score. Ain't got nobody to tell it to.
Now, don't you worry. I'll stop by tomorrow and you can tell it to me.
Hey, I kind of like that.
Come on, Joe.
Nobody goes in, not even room service. Nobody.
One out of two adults is overweight. And because overweight not only detracts from appearance, but impairs health and shortens life, your physician is your best counsel on weight control. Metrical was developed to help you lose weight and avoid regaining it. And now, Metrical is available in new liquid form, ready to drink. Although most people prefer their Metrical cold, it can be stored anywhere before opening without refrigeration. No risk of spoilage or loss of vital nutrients. You can take Metrical liquid anywhere. Simply open, pour, and drink. Delicious by any standard. Pleasing in texture, without sacrificing high protein content or appetite satisfaction. Your diet is easier to live with because Metrical fits into the way you live. Try Metrical, the established product with clinically proven safety and effectiveness.
Haven't seen any of this since Korea.
Hand grenade fragments.
Somebody really wanted him.
Yeah. I'll see you in a minute.
Thank you.
All right, come out. I said, come on out.
Glad to see a friendly face. Are you the police?
Nope. Mike Shayne. Yeah. Sit down. Well, what happened?
What happened? You tell me. I was reading a magazine. Somebody knocked on the door. When I opened it, I didn't see anyone. Then I stepped out into the hall and bang. Hey, was I robbed or anything?
No, but a man was killed in the room below yours.
Killed?
By a hand grenade. Lowered through that heating vent.
Who was she?
She was knocked out and tied and gagged and thrown in there.
Did you see anyone, miss?
No. Say, I must look terrible. I'll put on some lipstick.
So this is where it came from?
Yeah. Killer must have phoned Harry first to make sure he'd be near the vent, then lowered the hand grenade.
I'll have the boys check for fingerprints.
Well, our friend probably wore gloves. What's this? Grease of some kind.
Yeah, I'll run it through the lab.
Will you be all right now, miss?
Yes, thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Let's stop by Draco's flower shop. Good night, miss.
Good night.
Stake it out. No, thanks. Teletype from New York. You hit pay dirt on those fingerprints. The guy in the flower shop is not Jimmy Draco.
Who is he?
A guy named Dave Owens, arrested 4 months ago, suspicion of breaking and entering a warehouse. Tried to heist arms and ammunition. Released lack of evidence.
Arms and ammunition. Ties in, doesn't it? A hand grenade for a murder weapon?
McCord. Okay, thanks. The lab. The spectrograph indicated traces of cosmoline in the heel print.
Protective grease for guns, huh?
What GI whoever cleaned the new rifle will forget that goo.
Mind if I take this with me?
No, go ahead. We have a copy.
Check with you later.
Yes.
I'm Mike Shayne, a private investigator.
Oh, yes, of course.
I'm sorry to disturb you right now. Have we ever met?
I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
Somehow you look familiar to me.
Is there anything I can do for you?
Oh, this just came down from the New York police.
The Owens case, eh?
Now, according to this, the arms he hijacked were headed for your country. So as local counsel, I thought you might be able to give me some information about it. Anything at all.
Well, there were several suspects arrested at home. I could cable for their dossier.
Well, that
certainly appreciate that.
Consider it done. Will you join us?
I'd like to, but I can't spare the time right now.
Mr. Shayne, my country is a tortured place. I hope no more weapons fall into the wrong hands.
I understand. We'll keep you posted.
Chief, my people want to settle on some of your land. They send you offerings, nice beads and a looking glass.
Got them beads, got them looking glass.
And this, old chief.
Beech nut, peppermint gum. My land, your land, old brother.
Yes, sir. If it's real refreshment you want, just order up some beech nut peppermint gum. Beech nut peppermint gives you real double-barreled enjoyment. That's because it's made from fresh and fragrant mint leaves. Their tantalizing aroma and freshness make beech nut peppermint gum so tempting, cool, delicious. That fine mint flavor makes beech nut peppermint so refreshing, so satisfying to your taste. Beech nut peppermint gum. The gum that sparkles your smile, your breath, your whole sense of enjoyment. Look for it at your favorite gum counter and reach for beech nut.
What is Dave Owens to you?
A friend, a good friend.
But you knew he was mixed up in gun running.
No.
You knew he was arrested in New York?
No.
What did you do tonight?
We took a ride.
Where?
Nowhere.
Mrs. Draco, there was traces of cosmoline on the soles of your shoes.
I don't even know what that is.
It's a heavy grease used for packing new guns. The spectrograph doesn't make mistakes. Now, where is your husband?
I don't know.
We think you do.
I want to go home. Will you please let me go home?
Take over.
Mr. Draco, why don't you level with us? Let her go.
Now what?
Harry told us the truth about Draco, right?
Yeah.
But she let Owens take Draco's place. Why?
Because she's working with him. Or she's trying to protect somebody.
But who?
Her husband. Draco?
Now, he might still be alive and she might know it. Either way, she's no good to us here. Let her go and she might take us somewhere.
Mrs. Draco, you're in a lot of trouble.
Okay, Benson. You can go now, Mrs. Draco.
Thanks a lot. It's about time.
Take her home, Benson.
No, save the escort. I can make it on my own.
What's she doing back here?
Hello?
I've been trying to get you for 2 hours. What's happened?
The police questioned me.
You didn't tell them anything?
No, nothing. Nothing.
What about the telegram?
It hasn't come yet.
Okay. I'm going to call you every 5 minutes. When the telegram arrives, you give me the message, you burn it, then you get out of there. Understand?
I understand.
And in case you get any ideas. It's your wife. Rosalind?
Oh!
Jimmy?
Rosalind, do what he says.
Code?
Yeah, it looks like it.
You've got no right.
From what I saw, the key is this seed catalog. Let's see, the first word grouping is 23 dozen petunias, one variety of 2 cents. Check this out. Page 23, line 1, second word.
Now the word is truck.
Okay, page 18, 10th line, fourth word.
We'll take care of him when I get back.
Rosalind's done what you told her.
She's been a good girl. You were a lucky man, Draco. You just got mixed up in the wrong business.
Palm. The last word is palm.
Okay, so the message reads, truck arrives 3 a.m., 4th and Palm. What's in the truck, Mrs. Draco?
Nothing. There's no truck. You're making a mistake.
Okay, I'll have just time enough to get down here.
Mr. Shayne. If you stop that truck, my husband will die.
We're going to stop it, Mrs. Draco. But the more information we have, the better chance your husband will have. Now, what's in the truck?
Machine guns and automatic rifles.
Your husband's been running guns?
We've been using the shop as a clearinghouse.
Well, why the special arrangements for tonight?
This was a big cargo. They had to be careful. Jimmy was supposed to find a warehouse and then meet the truck.
But now it'll be Owens instead.
Yes.
Did Owens kill Harry Burke?
No, he was with me all evening. He'd let me see Jimmy.
Where?
A warehouse on the waterfront.
Could you find it again?
No, I was blindfolded. Mr. Shayne, don't let them kill him. He promised we'd get out of the business.
Joe, stay here and call McCord. Tell him to meet us one block west of 4th and Palm. Come on, Benson.
Here comes McCord.
Where's the truck?
Any minute now.
Truck arrived right on schedule.
How about letting me go?
Sorry.
I won't cop out on you. If I did, I'd go to jail myself.
No, Drago, you're not gonna cop out on us. But for a better reason.
Deal with you. I've still got access to a lot of stuff.
Save it.
Don't be a fool.
recognize their cosmoline.
Burke's killer had it on his shoes.
Well, how do you like that?
What is it?
I think I know who killed Harry Burke.
So do I.
Stop by your office on the way. Come on.
Mr. Shayne.
Senor Pardo. Sergeant McCord.
Pardo. Please, come in, gentlemen.
Thank you.
To what do I owe the pleasure of seeing you at this hour?
You wanted to be kept up to date on the gun running, I believe.
Why, yes, but I didn't expect development so soon.
And we try to work fast.
I see. Won't you sit down?
Well, the fact is, we're closing the case right now. Both the gun running and the murder of Harry Burke.
Harry Burke? I'm afraid I don't understand.
The man you killed because he saw you and your partner, Dave Owen, snatch Jimmy Draco.
Mr. Shayne, I don't know what you are talking about.
You see, Pardo, Harry Burke did identify you.
I don't have to tolerate this.
Burke picked out this mugshot at police headquarters. Notice the resemblance? That's why I thought I knew you.
This is absurd. It's a picture of a common criminal.
That's right, but it looks like you.
Mr. Shayne, your surmise is fantastic.
By any chance, did you lose a button?
Why, no.
We found this one where Draco was beaten up. And I'll bet we find cosmoline on the heel of one of your shoes.
Let's go.
Do you have tired walls? Do they need to be brightened up with a fresh new paint job? Well, brighten them up the quick, easy way with Pittsburgh Rubberized Wall Hide, the best wall paint you can buy. Rubberized Wall Hide goes on easy. Dries in just 20 minutes to a tough, hard finish you can wash again and again. And here's exciting news. It's Pittsburgh Paint's $100,000 Wall Hide Contest. Grand prize, two 1961 Rambler cars. Other prizes include famous Westinghouse ranges, Revco built-in refrigerator freezers, Supreme knife sharpeners, and many more. Over 1,000 in all. And it's easy to enter, easy to win. Here's what you do. Get Wall Hide and tell us why you like it. For an entry blank and full details on this exciting $100,000 contest, see your Pittsburgh paint dealer.
Okay, send her in, Lucy. Well, hello, Mrs. Draco.
Mr. Shay, I suppose you knew I was out on bail.
Yeah.
I spoke to Jimmy, and we're going to give the authorities a full story on the gun running ring. I hope it'll make it easier for us.
Yeah, from what I understand, it will. Would you care for a drink?
Yes. Yes, I'd like one. I really came to thank you, Mr. Shayne. Without you, Jimmy would have been dead.
Well, you mean without Harry Burke. He had a lot more to do with saving Jimmy's life than I did. Here's to him.
Harry Burke.
Here are some exciting moments from next week's Michael Shayne mystery. You had a little trouble with Ernie Trask.
You hear that, Seagreen? I've had trouble with Ernie. Shayne, if you check out everybody who's had trouble with that hothead, you're going to go through a lot of shoe leather.
Was it you that took a shot at him?
Not saying yes, not saying no.
A man was murdered. I've got the proof right here.
Don't, please don't.
Gun. You all right, Mike?
Like I said, I got style.
Tonight's Michael Shayne was brought to you by Handy Wrap, the clear new economy sandwich wrap for lunchboxes, and by new Men and Break, world's first man-sized deodorant with a wide roller top. New Men and Break. We'll be right back.